Amazon Frogbit, friend or foe? For many aquarists, it's a bit of both. This plant can be a real beauty when it's thriving, but a real pain when it's not. Today, we're going to turn you into a Frogbit expert. By the end of this video, you know exactly how to keep your Frogbit happy, healthy, and under control. Picture this. A pristine aquarium, the water crystal clear, just waiting for that perfect touch of green. That's where Amazon Frogbit comes in. You know, this little plant can be a real game changer for your tank, but it's not always smooth sailing. That's why we're here, to turn you into a Frogbit master. I've got a special trick up my sleeve that's going to make your life so much easier. Trust me, you're going to want to stick around for this one. Get it wrong, and you could end up with a tangled mess. But get it right, you'll have a stunning, low-maintenance tank that practically takes care of itself. So are you ready to transform your aquarium into a thriving Frogbit paradise? Let's do this. All right, you're ready to create that Frogbit paradise. But here's the thing. Frogbit can be a bit of a diva. Ever wonder why it sometimes takes over tanks like a weed and other times just gives up? There's a crucial factor most aquarists overlook, and it's making all the difference. Let's talk about this little plant from Central and South America. It's not just a pretty face floating on your tank's surface. Frogbit's got some serious skills when it comes to cleaning your water. You know how we're always worried about nitrates, ammonia, and nitrites in our tanks? Well, Frogbit is like nature's own filter, soaking up these excess nutrients like nobody's business. Take a closer look at those thick, spatula-shaped leaves. See that spongy underside? That's not just for show. It's what keeps Frogbit floating and looking so lush. But it's also part of what makes this plant such a powerhouse at cleaning your tank water. Now, here's where things can get a bit tricky. Frogbit reproduces fast. I mean real fast. If you're not careful, you might wake up one day to find your tank looking more like a floating meadow than an aquarium. But don't worry. I've got some tips to help you keep that growth in check. One thing you need to know about Frogbit is that it loves its light. We're talking about bright, consistent light. Without enough of it, your Frogbit might start looking more yellow than green. And trust me, nobody wants a sad, pale Frogbit floating around their tank. But light isn't the only thing Frogbit is picky about. This plant has some strong opinions about water movement, too. Remember how I said Frogbit could be a bit of a diva? Well, this is where that really shows. Too much water flow and those delicate roots can get damaged. Too little and you might end up with a stagnant water. We're aiming for that sweet spot. Just enough movement to keep things fresh, but not so much that your Frogbit feels like it's on a roller coaster. Now, you might be thinking, with all those nutrients it's soaking up, surely Frogbit doesn't need anything else, right? Well, not quite. Even though Frogbit is great at absorbing nutrients from your tank water, it can still benefit from a little extra fertilizer, especially if you notice the leaves starting to look a bit sad. Now, while we're on the topic of Frogbit care, let's talk about really what makes this plant tick. You might think you've got the hang of aquarium plants, but Frogbit has a surprise in store. There's one factor that can turn your Frogbit from mediocre to magnificent, and it's not what you'd expect. Let's dive into the secret world of Frogbit. This little floating wonder is all about balance, especially when it comes to water movement. You see, Frogbit has some strong opinions about how it likes to be pushed around, or not pushed around, as the case may be. Too much flow, and those delicate roots will break faster than you can say aquarium. Not enough, and you're looking at stagnant water and unhappy plants. So, how do we find that sweet spot? I like to call it the Goldilocks zone. Not too fast, not too slow. In my experience, the best way to achieve this is by strategically placing your filter output. You want to create a gentle current that keeps your frogbit moving, but doesn't send it on a wild ride around your tank. Try positioning your output to create a circular flow, or use a spray bar to diffuse the current. But water flow isn't the only thing frogbit is picky about. Remember how I mentioned light earlier? Well, let me tell you, frogbit likes its light. Like I like my coffee, strong. Without enough light, your frogbit will start looking more yellow than green. And trust me, nobody wants a sad, pale frogbit floating around their tank. Now, you might be thinking, with all those nutrients it's soaking up, surely frogbit doesn't need anything else, right? Well, not quite. Even though frogbit is great at absorbing nutrients from your tank water, it can also still benefit from a little extra fertilizer now and then. I've had great results using products like Aquarium Co-op's Easy Green. Just a small dose can make a big difference in keeping your frogbit lush and vibrant. Here's a pro tip. Before you introduce frogbit to your tank, gives those little roots a little trim. I know it might seem counterintuitive, but trust me on this one. Trimming those roots helps the plant acclimate better to its new home, and it prevents things from getting too messy. Plus, it encourages new growth, healthy root growth. One more thing to keep in mind, frogbit doesn't like getting its leaves wet. I know, it sounds crazy for an aquatic plant, but it's true. Too much water on the top of the leaves can lead to rotting. So when you're managing your water levels, make sure you're not constantly splashing water onto the frogbit's leaves. All right, so we've covered the basics of frogbit care, but here's where things get really interesting. Do you know what that frogbit can actually reduce the frequency of your water changes? It's true. And I'm about to show you how this floating plant can become your tank's secret weapon. You see, frogbit isn't just a pretty face floating on your tank's surface. It's a powerhouse when it comes to filtering your water. Remember how we talked about frogbit soaking up excess nutrients? Well, that's the key to this game-changing technique. Here's the secret. By regularly removing some of your frogbit, you're actually removing excess nutrients from your tank. It's like doing a water change, but easier. I know, it sounds almost too simple to be true, but trust me, this little trick can transform your entire approach to tank maintenance. Let me break it down for you. As frogbit grows, it absorbs nutrients from the water. These are the same nutrients that in excess can cause problems in your tank. Just by harvesting some frogbit regularly, you're essentially exporting these nutrients out of your aquarium's ecosystem. Now, you might be wondering, okay, how often should I do this? Well, that depends on your tank-specific needs. A rule of thumb is to remove about a quarter of your frogbit every week or two. But here's the cool part. You can actually use Frogbit as an indicator of your tank's nutrient levels. If your frog bed is growing like crazy, it might be a sign that you're overfeeding your fish. On the flip side, if it's struggling to grow, you might need to add some fertilizer. It's like having a living, floating nutrient test kit. But here's where timing becomes crucial. You want to remove the frog bit before it starts to deteriorate. If you wait too long, those absorbed nutrients will just be released back into the water as the plant breaks down. So keep an eye on your frog bit and remove it while it's still healthy and thriving. Now I know what you're thinking. Does this mean I can skip water changes entirely? Well, not quite. This technique doesn't replace water changes completely, but it can definitely reduce how often you need to do them. In many cases, you could cut your water changes in half. But it's not just about making your life easier, although that's definitely a nice bonus. This method actually creates a more stable environment for your fish. Instead of big, sudden changes in water chemistry from large water changes, you're constantly removing small amounts of nutrients. This gradual approach is much closer to what happens in nature. And let's not forget about the other benefits of Frogbit. While it's busy cleaning your water, it's also providing shelter for your fish and helping to recreate their natural habitat. Those long, dangling roots are perfect hiding spots for shy fish or even fry. All right, we've come a long way with our Frogbit journey. From understanding what makes this plant tick to mastering some pretty cool care techniques. Remember, success with Frogbit is all about balance, the right flow, the right light, and the right amount of plants. It's like conducting an orchestra where every element plays its part. Now it's your turn to take what you've learned and apply it to your tank. Trust me, the results will speak for themselves. You're not just growing plants here. You're creating a thriving ecosystem that's healthier for your fish and easier for you to maintain. That's what I call a win-win. Now, with these skills under your belt, you're way on your way to becoming a frog bit expert. So go ahead, give it a shot. Click on this next video for more aquarium adventures that you don't want to miss. And I will see you there.